Hi, everybody. Welcome to this special production. This video is going to be a bit different from the usual stuff that we do because I wanted to take the moment and, I guess, provide a service to the Amazon seller community, especially if you're a brand owner on Amazon. One of the most important things for you in order to have your Amazon business thrive and last, you know, for a long, long time is having your products rank the highest as possible on Amazon, you know, on your category, your subcategory, whatever it is. You know, the mission is to get a good ranking, because if you do, you're going to get all the traffic that you need from Amazon and you're going to explode, hopefully. So what we decided to do is take the moment with Izabela Hamilton, our lovely guest from the episode on Prime Talk. We did a special episode with her. So we kind of dove into her life and her life story, which is really and sincerely amazing. So, you know, if you haven't seen the episode yet, I encourage you to, you know, visit our YouTube page, channel. Just, you know, put Getida and look for Izabela Hamilton. Check out her episode. It's going to blow your mind off. But this episode, Izabela is going to focus on really what she does. What's her magic? What does she do? And RankBell, her company, does for Amazon sellers, and how does it all help? So, Izabela, hi again. Welcome, you know, welcome to our small little corner. And thank you for joining us.
Thank you. It's such a pleasure being with you. I feel like every time I talk to you, like, we get to know each other better. And there's just so much synergy. And you love helping people and I love helping people. And, you know, I'm just so glad that we're able to do this together and, you know, teach sellers a little bit of how ranking works, because a lot of people come into this business and, you know, first of all, they think, you know, just because they have an amazing product, their product is going to automatically rank. So what happens is when that doesn't happen, they get disappointed and then they leave the game too early without knowing, you know, that there's this, you know, I don't even want to call them tricks because they're not really tricks, but they are part of the business, you know, just like, you know, back in the day, you know, a lot of people used to advertise like on TV or radio or on huge billboards. Now we have different type of advertising. And, you know, when it comes to Amazon, to get the most eyes on your product, you have to be on page one. So I guess that's a little bit of an introduction on what we're going to talk, but I'm just so excited to be here, Yoni. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you a million times.
Our pleasure, really. So yeah, you just segued into what we want to touch and focus on in this, you know, video production. So take us there. You know, I sell on Amazon, you know, even if I just got started or even if I'm established, what is the opportunity for me with RankBell? What are you guys doing? What is this all about? What is all the buzz about?
So with RankBell, you know, we started this company and we touched a little bit on this on our podcast, by the way. Thank you for mentioning that. You know, we started it as almost like a quality control service until it became something bigger. It became a ranking service. And we realized that the most crucial aspect of a brand on Amazon is how high you can rank, how fast you can rank. Now, that's not to say that those who have like missed that window, you know, because a lot of people talk about the honeymoon period, which is great, but a lot of them are scared, like, oh my God, I missed the honeymoon period. What happens? So this service does not.
So let's touch the honeymoon for a second. Just so I want to give some of the audience some perspective. So honeymoon period, as far as I understand it, right? Correct me if I'm wrong, Izabela, is when you launch a product on Amazon, Amazon likes new products. So it tends to give the sellers and their listing some love, some like on a honeymoon period where they're more attracted to you. There's more romance in the air. You get some more exposure. But after that period, if you don't really clutch it in and make it a successful marriage, they might, you know, drop you off and you're going to be, your listing, your ranking is going to fall to the cemetery of Amazon listings or something like that. Did I get it right?
So, yes, but okay. So let's say you're launching your product today and you're not doing anything, but because you don't have, you know, money for a ranking campaign, or maybe you don't have enough stock, whatever the reason is, you just kind of let it sit there. If that happens, Amazon looks at it as, you know, this product is not really doing anything. So they will put you at the end. Not because they hate you, but because Amazon is always looking to promote products that are selling. Why? Because they want money, right? So when a brand new product comes in town, Amazon does give you that extra love. And they do it because they want to collect the data on you. So it's not that they're, you know, again, that they're liking you more or less. It's just you're new and they want to know what you are capable of. Are you doing PPC? Are you doing any ranking? How fast is this product selling? That is really what the honeymoon period is.
And essentially, it's an audition. Every new product that comes in, Amazon runs it through an audition. If they like the voice, on to the next stage. If you don't,
That's exactly, you couldn't have said it better, because a lot of people think, oh, honeymoon period is just this like little thing that happens. No, it's really Amazon looking into you, checking on you, gathering the data. So the more you can do for them, the more PPC you can do, the more ranking campaign you can do, where you get all these sales, you're basically proving to Amazon that you're here to stay, that you are a good product. Now, this period can last anywhere from 1 month to 3 months. Nobody really knows. It's always, there's always a debate around it. It's like, you know, 1 month. I've seen it go as long as like 3 months. But again, it's not a set period of time. It's just the time it takes Amazon, again, to gather that data on you. So, but if you haven't done anything, it doesn't mean that you have to throw that product in the trash and not do anything with it. You can still relaunch, what we call relaunch and re-rank. It's, you know, I've seen it work just as good as the honeymoon period. Like, I can't say, oh my God, if your product, you haven't done anything, like it's forever dead. We've brought products back from dead just with the simple fact.
I can put it this way. You know, you got into the audition, you didn't do so well, you kind of got rejected. So RankBell is almost like an agent saying, mm-hmm. I can get you another audition.
Yes.
I'll get you a second audition. If you blow it out of the game, you got the gig, you got the position, you got the rank, you're going to keep rocking it.
Is that another fair way to look at it? Because it is an audition. And for an audition, you do have to put on your best face, right? So a lot of products we bring on page one, and then they don't have that best face. They don't have the images. Their listing is not up to date. So what happens is they kind of start falling back down. This is one of the reasons why the ranking doesn't stick. And another reason is, you know, again, you didn't give Amazon enough data. So let's say we are doing a ranking campaign for you. We're doing this black pen. We're doing 10 units giveaway per day for 10 days. 10, 10, 10, 10. And then you get to page one. What happens is when you get to page one is you start getting organic sales, which is what the whole purpose of doing a ranking campaign and doing PPC is. But you may not get 10 a day right away. You may only get 4 organic orders a day, and you may get from PPC another 10. So what happens now, you went from 10 orders a day to 6. This is one of the mistakes a lot of people do. They completely stop. So what happens is you're giving Amazon this data. Every single day you're doing 10 orders, but now you got to page one and you're not doing that much.
So I think you jumped a few steps here. So these 10 orders a day, let's get to that point. So you're telling me, okay, so I'm an Amazon seller. I'm about to launch something or already did launch. So you can help me either way. You can help me with my first audition and help me with my second audition if the first audition did not go well, right? Mm-hmm. So either way, okay, what do you do for me? I say, okay, I want to work with RankBell. What do you guys actually do in the audition? For the auditions, talk to me about that, the ranking, the whole, or the reviews, the whole thing. Unpackage everything for me.
Of course. So you will come to us as a, you know, brand new client of ours, and you will say, I have this pen that I want to rank, but, you know, the competition is fierce. We're looking at CPR, which is a tool in the Cerebro of Helium 10, for those that don't know. And they see, okay, this pen, for me to rank it on page one, I need to do 20 giveaways a day. So at RankBell, we like to scale that back just a little bit, because we've noticed that with Helium 10, some of these numbers are just a little bit exaggerated. I'm not sure why the reason is. It's probably, you know, depending on competition, what they do. But we realize that if we start with a smaller number, we tend to achieve the same results as if you were to do a bigger giveaway.
So let me get this straight so far. So, you know, I start working with RankBell. You guys run through a test, you know, using the Helium 10 tool called Cerebro that says, mm-hmm. you know, for you to kind of start ranking your product, either in the first audition or second, doesn't really matter. You're going to have to kind of give away X amount of units, okay, every day to do giveaways. And what does a giveaway mean? I want to give super basic on this, right? So in case anybody listening to this, there's no questions asked, right? Yes. So essentially, when you give away a product on Amazon, essentially what happens is somebody buys your product, And then, you know, Amazon considers it as a sale was generated, and they like it, and your conversion rate improves, and then also your ranking improves. So every sale moves it up the ranks. So when you do giveaways, essentially you're gonna have to pay money back to these consumers who bought the product. So is that what you guys do? You actually facilitate that?
Correct. We facilitate that, and these are buyers who are interested in your product. So they're not just freebie seekers. This is the difference between what we do and like run a ManyChat, let's say, sequence. So we have a large community of thousands and thousands of buyers. So if I am doing a promotion on this pen, only those who are interested in pen will apply for this promotion. So we're not just going to get everybody just because this is a free item. So when you come to us, we are doing this giveaway. So we find these what we call influencers. They're essentially influencers. And we say, we have this pen. Are you interested in, you know, testing the product? And they'll say yes or no. If they are interested, we will say, you know, we gamify it a little bit for them. We say, you know, we have this pen. Would you do us a favor? Try to see if you can find it by this key term, black pen for toddlers, let's say. Try to see what page does it land when it comes to searching organically. So they'll say, oh, I looked for this pen. I found it on page 4. Okay, thank you very much. I appreciate that. Do you mind like reading through the listing? Is there anything that you see that's different? You know, click in, click out. We want them to experience a real sale. It's almost like when they used to do back in the day, what was that? Like personal shoppers, like those secret shoppers, kind of like this. So we gamify it for them. They feel like they're doing something for us, and in return they get this product for free. So we're not incentivizing them with money in any way. This is a product that they're interested in as it is, and then we do this exchange together. So they're looking for this product, they're finding it, they add it to their card, and they buy it as
okay. So
as
somebody, let me help you tell you, let me package it, see if I got this straight. So essentially, if I'm an Amazon seller, I want to use RankBell. You guys essentially have a community of consumers where you gamify the whole thing for them. So they're consumers, hardcore consumers who are legitimately interested in, you know, these types of products to begin with. You know, you're going to match them with the consumers who are interested in their type of products. So essentially, if I'm the seller, you guys are going to say, we need you to allocate a budget for this campaign, for this RankBell campaign. You know, let's say it's going to be X amount of dollars per unit. Give me a number. What's a good amount of dollars per unit usually, typically? For every product that I give away, every unit, the budget is actually what the cost of the product?
Yes, it's cost of the product plus the cost of the service, which, you know, we can talk about it later because I want, you know, whoever is listening right now to get like a...
Yeah, we're going to give them a special promotion.
But yeah, so you don't have to plan. Just like you're planning for bringing your product, just like you're planning for saving some money for PPC, you would do the same for RankBell. The good thing about using RankBell is this can go towards your taxes. This is a marketing expense.
Yeah, same way I want to take from the food industry. You know how many times they want to launch a new product, they go to the supermarket and they give you free samples, tastes.
Yes.
You know, if it's a new type of cheese, here you go. It's all a marketing budget, a marketing campaign. So you're going to have to allocate a bunch of funds that are equal to the cost of goods for you. Essentially, mm-hmm. You're giving away products away. It's going to be 10 or 100 or 1,000, whatever it is going to be allocated. So, you know, I'm going to have to allocate this amount of inventory as, call it samples or marketing expenses. In addition, there's going to be a cost per unit paid to RankBell to basically do the matchmaking where they match make you and the consumer. The consumer eventually makes a little bit legitimate purchase, and then you start ranking and ranking and ranking, and you get your position, and that jump starts your listing and your business to a new dimension. Is that kind of the...
That's exactly what it is. So let's say, you know, every single day we have 10 orders per day, we rebate the consumers on our side. Again, they're doing us a favor, and our favor to them is, hey, you're testing this product for us, you can have it for free. And, you know, we do this like the most perfect way. We send them a check. Everything is done through QuickBooks, is done through an outside company, a third party that sends all the checks. Everything is super, super flawless. And the seller receives a report every single day. They can log into their dashboard and they can see, okay, today I had 10 orders. This is the order number. They can verify it. Plus, we have an account specialist for every single person that comes into RankBell, every single seller. So you're never in the dark. You don't have to like send an email, wait like 2-3 days. You can send us a message on WhatsApp or anything and we respond right away. Our whole team is here, by the way, in US. So we don't have any overseas VAs that, you know, maybe work on different timelines. We wanted everybody in the company to be on this time because we know how important that is. Because sometimes like your product may run out of stock, your your listing can go down for any reason, and we're there to tell you every step of the way, hey, this is what happened. And you know, we're very proud of that.
Yeah, so the experience is, you know, there's visibility, you understand what's going on in real time, there's support. And once again, the simple idea is that you, when you come to RankBell, maybe your product was in page 10 mm-hmm. and ranked, you know, somewhere in the bottom or middle of the chart. After a few weeks, or maybe a few months of running this with real consumers, with all the visibility, you hopefully get to, you know, page one and you're top of the charts.
Yeah. And it doesn't even take that long. Like, we realize, I know, you know, ranking is scary, and you come in with a product and you're like, holy cow, this pen has, you know, it's on page one, has been selling for so long. They're making, you know, hundreds of thousands of dollars per month. It's very scary. You're like, how am I supposed to compete with that? So a lot of people think, oh my God, I'm going to have to get like 2000 reviews or 5,000 or whatever the competitors have. If you create a beautiful listing, if you have very nice images, and we get you to page one, even with 10, 20, 30 reviews, we see that this product starts to sell very, very well. Like, you don't have to wait years to become the other guy's competition. Just by you having this and being on page one, you're going to start generating a lot of sales without having 3,000 reviews, because this is a fear that every seller has, and it can put them off from picking a product like that. They're like, oh, you know, I was thinking of going with this product, but I'm not going to because it's super competitive. So I'm here to tell people, like, no, feel free to be a little bit more courageous, because that's all you need. And, you know, today we have so many amazing services. Like, there's just so many amazing good PPC companies. You have RankBell for ranking. You have different companies for images. You really have everything. But what I noticed, Yone, is a lot of people, you know, have this fear, like, oh my God, now I have to spend money. They forgot, like, what it used to take before to market. Like, right now we pay nothing. If you think about it, Facebook ads, if you think about PPC, this is not really expensive. It's very cheap to market your company, to make actual real money, not a hobby, real money. With today's day, how we have, you know, the e-commerce, we have internet, like, we really have everything we need, everything on our plate. And we say, oh, it may be too expensive. Like, when I hear that, I'm like, dude, this is like your business. This is not a hobby. Like,
yeah, help you with this. Yeah, this is something I preach almost every day. If you're thinking you're just going to jump into the Amazon landscape as a hobby, as a side hustle, no. If you are listening to this and you consider yourself a pro and this is your business, this is what you want to do for the next 10, 20, 30 years, that's it. You spare no expense in terms of building your business, because every expense is another brick in your empire. Think of it as bricks. This is going to build your walls. It's not going to go down the toilet. It's going to build your walls. So good ranking, okay, you're having your page on the right, and your basically your listing on the right product page or the first page, is like a brick. It's hard to penetrate afterwards. So yeah, this is building an empire. It's not about being leisure. It's not about buying a Rolex and looking great. This is about building your business. And especially if you want to consider yourself as a you know, as a pro, or, you know, as a business man or woman. So yeah, if you were just in it for the side hustle, make a quick buck, it's not for you. And it's probably not going to be for you for the long term. And on a personal level, I don't advocate that too much, because it is a pro game, because there's so much opportunity to make a career out of it and make a good living or a fortune even. So why not try to reach there instead of making a few thousand dollars and get out? It almost doesn't make sense to me. So
yeah, it's a very good business model. And, you know, a lot of people think, oh, is Amazon, like, you know, overrated? Like, is it too late to get in? No, it's not. I mean, look what happened during COVID, like how Amazon exploded. Like, there's people who have never logged into Amazon before, even though, you know, Amazon has a lot of users, but because of COVID, people are forced, you know, not go to an actual store. They had to stay at home. So a lot of new subscriptions to Amazon happen. Also a lot of new sellers. But what we see is that, you know, the game is getting just a little bit harder. Again, you know, there's just so much competition. That is not a reason for you to give up. There is not a reason for you to not start, because this is a very viable business. I mean, look at all the aggregators that are coming into our market. Why do you think that is? These companies, if you're listening out there, these companies are literally created. They are waiting for you to start killing it on Amazon so they can buy your company. Like, what?
Like, it's another civil platter that was, you know, given as a major gift to the Amazon seller community, where, yes, you know, they're telling you, just show us the data, show us the results that you were able to rank, you know, to the first page, and it's consistent, and you can keep doing it, and there's revenue, and there's profits, and it, you know, repeats and repeats and repeats. That's it. Their checkbook is open, and then it's not a fantasy. This is done by paying close attention to what's available for you out there, the solutions, the data. It's all data driven. It's all based on data. So if you're ranked right now 1 million, and you're gonna be ranked 1,000, world of a difference. That's data. Simple math, right? So pack it all that up. There's a great opportunity to do amazing things here. So I think I got the gist of it. Amazon, I'm an Amazon seller. RankBell has its own community of consumers where you guys do the matchmaking, and you got a seller needs to allocate a budget of inventory plus per unit cost, you know, for you guys to do with the matchmaking. So all these purchases come in, and then the ranking is built, and then the seller can, you know, keep rocking it. So tell us, what kind of a special offer you prepare for, you know, for our followers?
So usually we have a setup fee, which is $499, and we have our fee is $15 per unit, but I want to give this to your community. I want to remove that setup fee completely, so no $499. And for your first promotion, because I want a lot more people to test this, I know it works. I want you to know that it works. So instead of $15, we will do $10 a unit for your first campaign. And I think you will be able to see a huge difference in overall sales and overall everything. Because a lot of people, you know, they've been stagnant for so long on page 2 or 3 or 4 that, you know, they're only getting those trickled in sales here and there for those who maybe are bored and are looking on page 2 and 3. And I know it hurts me to say this, but as consumers, myself included, and I don't know if it's the same for you, Oni, we don't have much time. Like, if I want to buy something for my kids,
touch and go. I touch it and I go.
I order and I go, especially for products that are under like $50, $100. If it's like $20, I don't even care if it's going to work. I need it in 2 days. I want it to be there. So true. You want to be on page one. You really want to, guys. Like, give this a try. If you ever even think of quitting Amazon, I want you to give this a try first, because you really have nothing to
lose. So you're saying if your product, you know, you failed the first audition, your products are kind of plateauing, you want to kind of break the routine a little bit, I think it's a no-brainer. So no setup costs. Instead of $500, this is all waived up. And you know, you're gonna allocate a certain amount of inventory. You already have that, so it's not an issue for you.
Yes, please. That's so important. Don't run out of stock. I don't want your money. Like, don't come to me if you don't have enough stock. Because what happens is, over and over again, Yoni, people expect the worst, but they don't expect the best. So don't come to me. Don't have, you know, all these units, and then we'll do our ranking campaign, and then they start selling, and then they run out of stock. I'm like, why didn't you plan for this to win?
Once again, it's a game for pros. This is if you're a pro, you're ready for that. You're ready for the explosion. The explosion comes in, you got the rank. All of a sudden, instead of selling 5 units a day, you're selling 500 units a day. You have a whole arsenal in your warehouse ready to be sold. So this is kind of the caliber that we're aiming to here.
Exactly. And if you run out of stock, again, don't despair. Bring back the stock. We'll re-rank it. You will fall out of rank. I'm telling you that right now. And again, not because Amazon hates you, but because other people are selling more than you. If you don't have anything to sell, you will fall back a little bit, but it's not the end of the world. But I want you to be prepared. If you come and rank with us, you will start getting sales. And I need you to be prepared. Whether if you don't have, I know the limit, it's actually getting up a little bit, thank God. But you know, if your limit, make sure you have them. I don't know, in your garage, make sure you have where you send into Amazon stock all the time, or maybe switch to FBM, whatever you need to do. Because once we start this, you will start the sales. And it may be better than you've ever seen your entire experience on Amazon. So don't always prepare for the worst, prepare for the best, because it happens more than you think. I see it every single day. They're like, I didn't know it was going to happen so fast. I didn't know it was this. And then they run out of stock, and then it breaks my heart, because then they have to redo it all over again.
Got it. Beautiful. All right. So guys, you know, once again, I hope you guys recognize here the opportunity. I wish I had this opportunity available when I was selling on Amazon. It will be you know, it will make life so much easier of being able to rank in such a smooth, classic way. So I hope, you know, this is all new to you, and you just, you know, are realizing this opportunity now, take action. Izabela and RankBell are there for you. They're going to waive off the $500. Instead of paying $50 per unit, you're going to pay $10 per unit. I think it's a no-brainer. Try it out. Give it a shot. Of course, if it's helpful and it's useful, share with others. You know, sharing is caring. You know, we're all here to help make this a better, you know, seller community and a better marketplace, you know, e-commerce and Amazon in particular. Izabela, thank you so much. Much appreciated. You know, keep rocking it up. I appreciate your inputs here. And that's it, everybody. Until next time.
Thank you.